Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner, and I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about how you can make simple generators without using std::generate, without needing coroutines, without requiring a heap, and of course, doing it all with lambdas. But before I continue, I do want to remind you that I am giving a C++ best practices class at NDC Tech Town in Kongsberg, Norway at the beginning of September in 2024. Be sure to check out the video description for a link to that. And since we're talking about lambdas, I'll remind you that I have a t-shirt store with my awesome Better Living Through Lambdas t-shirt. Okay, so I wanted some simple way of making a generator that behaves like a Python generator, but doesn't need standard generate or coroutines. And my favorite Fibonacci version that uses a lambda, we've talked about several times, including recently, which can somewhat unfortunately actually become a single line statement if we take advantage of the fact that the result of an assignment expression is a reference to the resulting value. Maybe you don't want to do that, but it's kind of cool. Now, what I wanted was some way to actually call this thing from a generator. Which might look something like this, but you can't simply just pipe a lambda through a view. I want to print the first 20 values in this Fibonacci generator, but I can't do it this simply. I need some sort of helper, and I came up with a way to do this. And it uses a utility that I'm guessing many of you have never used before, which is iota. And iota in the standard library simply generates a string of sequential integers. You could use it for filling a container, or you can use the views iota. It'll generate 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, etc. Now, I'm kind of abusing the situation here. So I am generating a range of integers. Okay. And then I am piping that through the transform view. Now, the transform view expects a callable that can take the input of the previous thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call this function func once with the value 0, then with the value 1, then with the value 2, etc. to infinity. Well, until size t wraps, something like that. Now, if I take this generator function and I pass it my lambda, I'm going to get code that doesn't compile again, because it is expecting a function that takes a single parameter. Now, if I have a generator, it's probably fair to ask it which value I want it to generate, but I don't really care about that integral input here, so I'm just gonna throw it away. And we can see that I actually do get code that prints the first 20 Fibonacci numbers. And it is shockingly straightforward, in my opinion, for how easy it was to implement this. So I take a callable, I am generating a new view that is the iota piped through the transform of that function. So it's calling that function however many times it takes with that integral. I am ignoring the integral and I'm just doing whatever I want to do, returning the next state of my function. And it generates so little code. In fact, most of the code that this is generating is actually the code that is around cout. If I use format print instead of cout, then we get something that approaches code that we could literally just read. This is call to format print, subtract 1 from our counter, jump if not equal to 7, where it does the shifting around of things, jumps back up to L2, and does the next calculation for our next Fibonacci number, which it calls print for, and etc. So yeah, a simple lightweight generator using just views and lambdas. And I think this is personally very interesting. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, learned something from it. There will be a link in the video description that will take you to this code example, along with all of the other planned and past and future episodes of C++ Weekly, if there's anything that you would like to have your input on. And I will see you in the next episode.